lot of guys trying to catch her, but she leads them on a wild goose chase.
You got that ace guy, you got my ace.
And she'll have fun, 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 till her daddy takes a T-bird away.
Fun, 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 till her daddy takes a T-bird away.
Fun, 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 or as I like to call it, fun cubed. From the Beach Boys kicks off this edition of Hello, Hamilton County. We'll have fun, fun, fun till Daddy takes the T-Bird away. Only the Beach Boys are not exactly boys anymore. Now we'll have fun, fun, fun till our kids take the cars away and they don't let us drive anymore. We're going to kind of evoke that era of the Beach Boys with one of our Hamilton County events in just a few moments. So that was the reason for playing that here on Hello, Hamilton County. I'm your hometown weatherman, meteorologist Paul Poteet, with all kinds of events, real events that are happening the weekend that starts up. On, May 14th, and we're in the middle of the month on Saturday. We're at the Westfield Playhouse, going to talk more about Silent Sky in just a few moments. I'm brought to you in part by my friends over at First Farmers Bank and Trust. You can reach them several ways by telephone at 317-376-1649. And they're now servicing Cicero. They're right there on Peru Street in Cicero at 1100 South Peru Street. And you can also find them online, of course, at www. I didn't do the HTTP for it. www.ffbt.com/Cicero. ffbt.com/Cicero. The lobby hours Monday through Thursday, that's from 9 a.m. until 4 p.m. Fridays from 9 till 5. Drive up is open Monday through Thursday from 8 until 5. And then on Fridays from 8 a.m. till 6 p.m. Saturdays 9 to noon. And they've got a sponsored segment in the weekly edition of the Hamilton County Reporter, of one which I happen to have right here. That when you're a subscriber, you get the weekly print edition. So they have a segment called Tell Me a Story that's in that every week. And they also have daily online ads that have more information. Again, I'll tell you how to subscribe later on. I'll tell you about Silent Sky right now. That's on stage at the new Westfield Playhouse. It's at 220 North Union Street in Westfield. It's the last weekend for it. This is the true story and the science of something that happened in the early 20th century at Harvard University's observatory. Astonishing discoveries await Henrietta Leavitt as she maps distant stars in distant galaxies. And it was much tougher to map back then. There were no GPS devices. There was no Hoosier AAA Motor Club. You couldn't get a nice triptych, you know, with the little routes highlighted in the yellow marker. No, she had to map on her own. But this brilliant, headstrong pioneer woman struggles for recognitions in a man's world of turn-of-the-century astronomy. So this whole production, it's interesting. It's kind of a blend of history and science and romance and family struggle, too. Interesting presentation that you got to catch this weekend. Friday, Saturday, and both of those nights at 7:30. There is a special live stream also on Saturday, May 15th at 7:30. And Sunday, a matinee presentation at 2:30. The new Westfield Playhouse. And again, that's 220 North Union. Go to westfieldplayhouse.org. Let me give you a phone number you can also call for tickets. It's 317-402-3341. $17 for adults 18 and older, $15 for seniors, $15 for students with ID. It is free for active military personnel and veterans with ID. And no walk-in seating is available. Reservations close 2 hours prior to curtain. They've got all kinds of protocols in place to keep everything clean and healthy. And the program is digital. You access it by scanning the QR code that's available in the lobby of the theater. It's all high-tech-like, as befits a play that features some science. Okay, we talked about fun, fun, fun earlier. There is a presentation by the Actors Theater of Indiana. It's a drive-in that they're doing on Friday night, May 14th, and it goes from 7 to 9 p.m. It's called Start Your Engines. The gang at ATI will get you moving at a special Carmel drive-in theater. Start your engines and drive on over to hear the first ATI drive-in of the year. Rev up for the Indy 500. The gang is back together to give you the music of the highways and byways of America from back in the days of King of the Road, trailers for sale or rent, to the surf music of the 1960s, which my older brother and sister tell me was really something. It's going to be some high-octane fun till your daddy takes the T-Bird away. You want some more information from the Actors Theater of Indiana? Please call this number. It's 317-590-7522. 317-590-7522 for the Actors Theater of Indiana at 620 South Rangeline Road, 7 to 9 Friday night. Prices range from $60 to $120. All right, now over to Fishers. We've done Westfield, Carmel. We're heading to Fishers for a reception that's called Our Reality, Our Dreams, and Embrace the Chaos. Out of chaos comes order. This is presented by the Fishers Arts Council, and that happens Friday evening from 6 to 8. It's absolutely free. 6 to 8 p.m., the photography of Freddie Kelvin and Tom Mueller in their joint exhibit. And that's going on at the Art Gallery at City Hall in Fishers. And Brenton Ferrand, who is the Alco featured artist, will also join with his exhibit. So the two exhibits together are Our Reality, Our Dreams, and Embrace the Chaos. Out of chaos comes order. Most artwork will be available for purchase. Several of the photographs are available in multiple size prints. And there will be entertainment, live musical guests, the Goodman Joven Duo. All right, I've got my week of weather coming up in just a few moments. Are we going to be able to replicate last Saturday's sunshine? That's ahead, along with Stu's News.
There's a shelter pet who wants to meet you. Meet one today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org. Adopt.
Hello, Hamilton County. It's Stu Clampett with some news from this week's reporter. At Tuesday's Noblesville Common Council meeting, Deputy Mayor Matt Light introduced two proposed ordinances that will increase vehicle registration fees in the city of Noblesville. Light presented to the council a proposal that would implement a motor vehicle wheel tax and an excise surcharge for all vehicles registered within city limits. You can read all the details at readthereporter.com. Our friends at Prime Life in Richmond are in need of drivers to help them continue to serve Hamilton County seniors with services like free and low-cost rides to medical appointments, grocery trips, and visits to Prime Life and more. If you'd like to learn what it takes to drive for Prime Life, go to primelifeinrichmond.org or read their ad in the Reporter.
All right, Paul. Laird John Sampson and I are going to go see Silent Sky and look through the Grand Universe telescopes this weekend. So how about some rain-free silent skies for us?
Well, was that a Scottish accent, right? That's the best Scottish accent I've heard since those Austin Powers movies. That was impressive, Stu. You're better off looking at the telescope, I would say, Friday night than Saturday night, because I think we'll be clouding up by Saturday night. Friday night should be okay. Our weather forecast is brought to you by Simplify IT. Now, I'm always thinking about the weather and Baxter and Mrs. Poteet. I don't have time to be thinking about IT problems, and so I recommend that you offload some of that and get it out of your head. When your IT department clocks out, Simplify IT clocks in. They've got emergency service that they offer from 5 to 10 p.m. weekdays and from 9 a.m. to 10 p.m. on weekends. They know that information technology is complicated, and so they invite you to simplify it by calling Simplify IT. The number, 866-987-2349, or go to simpleitworks.com. You can find them on Facebook also, Simple IT Works. Well, I think the highs are going to be generally in the upper 60s Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Remember last weekend we had that nice Saturday and then that lousy Sunday? Well, it looks like history is going to kind of repeat itself. Temperatures will remain below average through the weekend. I think the highs are going to be into the upper 60s. At least we don't have to worry about frost this weekend. Matter of fact, Friday looks like a nice day. Sunny sky. Saturday, partly sunny. Does cloud up Saturday night. And then we've got showers around on Sunday. Maybe some thunder. The high again will be into the upper 60s. And then I think showers are likely, maybe some thunderstorms on Monday. Maybe a little warmer then, 70 to the low 70s. And then daily chances of showers and storms are going to trade dry and cool for warm and wet here Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. I got a chance every day, and every day the highs get into the mid 70s. That's at and a little above average. Kind of what they say about the Hamilton County Reporter. Now, this is the print edition, which has local news. There's a story about the new county parking garage in Noblesville. Cicero Scouts are doing some great things. Court notices, sports pictures and stories. It's kind of a digest of some of what we cover every day online. Now, when you subscribe, you get them both. You get that once a week in your mailbox, and you get us in your email inbox every other day, including my updated forecast every day. And it's $12 a year. It's $1 a month. Do it right now while you're thinking of it. Go to readthereporter.com/subscribe and join our little family. And maybe sometime we'll take you out cruising. Unless the dad in our family, that's our publisher, unless daddy takes the T-Bird away. You won't do it, daddy. I'm not going to let you do it. Is anyone buying the fact that I remotely could be an 18-year-old throwing a temper tantrum at this point? All right, you have fun this weekend, and this beached weather boy will see you soon for Hello, Hamilton County.